Hi everybody, I'm Kirsty Meakin from Nao Nails. I'm going to do a set of nails inspired by my night out. Yes, I was let out for the day. Well, the evening. I went to a night at the musicals at Trenton Gardens, like an open air concert. And me and the girls went and we dressed up as 1950s style, inspired by Greece. So we're going to do 1950s nails. Don't be mistaken by thinking that these are nails that they would have wore in the 1950s, because this is not what they would have wore.
They would have been baby boomers.
Mm-hmm. They would have been baby boomers. So we've already got a set on. Our lovely model today, Vanessa, who was not going to knock anything as she puts her hand in the lamp, like she normally does. Just say, just one.
It was one.
It was like so big though, it was so bad. It was so big and so bad.
It cuts as multiple.
Yes, it does. If you never do it again, I will still go on about it. Right, so we're going to use this colour. I love this colour. I actually bought a dress off eBay, didn't I, Vanessa?
Mm-hmm. Did you have to do that for her?
No, she can buy clothes herself.
So, it's just the way that you said.
Because it was
didn't have an Essa.
No, she sold the dress. And it looked beautiful on eBay. I mean, I don't really go out in 1950s style clothes, but it was a rockabilly dress, style dress. And it got frills here and some little buttons here just for decoration. And it was one of them that went out like that. I even bought a petticoat for underneath. You know, to make it like a bit of a tutu-y kind of sticky out thing. Yeah, it came and it looked like somebody had screwed it up and put it in a bag. Because when I took it out, it was just all creased beyond recognition. It's like, what even is this? So I thought, it's fine, I shall iron it, you know. And I thought, well, I was running around, didn't really have much time to try it on. Tried it on at about 2 o'clock in the morning after the football presentation. And this was the night before going out. And yeah, I was just sorry I didn't wear that. it was built for somebody who has a torso of a giant, because I put it on the waist and then the shoulders were up here. I was like, what? I'd have to pull it underneath my bum, the waistline underneath my bum, to get it fit. It was awful, absolutely awful. It was cheap. You know, you buy cheap, you buy twice. And I did. So I had to race up to Hanley and find another dress, but I actually found a really nice dress, and it was this colour. And I really like this colour, so we're going to use this colour. And Vanessa loves this colour as well, don't you? And it's called Spring Meadow, and it's from the Pastel collection. And we're going to put this on all the nails, because I love it so much. I'm going to do two coats. It's got a really nice pigment as well. So I'm mixing Snow White and, I forgot the colour name, Spring Meadow, a little bit more white. Because I just wanted to have a hint of this teal colour, or turquoise, or whatever colour you want to call it, because I'm sure Adam will argue with me what colour it actually is.
Yeah, I think you're right in that. It's
yeah.
It's like Tiffany.
Yes. So in the 50s, there was lots of dots, polka dot, lots of stripes. And I want to do some polka dots that are slightly paler than the colour we've used. So I've just added a bit of white. So we're going to do some dots, some little polka dots. I'm using a dotting tool and I'm just pushing it out so it's a little bit larger.
Surprisingly, it didn't look like it was so much lighter on the paper, but it really is a lot lighter.
It is, yeah. It's soft enough. I didn't want it to be like really garish white. Do you know what? I'm going to get you cure that. You cure that in there, because I think you might not that. Oh, she was even careful bringing it out. Oh, Ness, thank you. Keep up the good work.
Can I get a gold star?
Oh, yeah. Now you get a teal dot.
Thank you.
So, I like to do polka dots in this formation. So I'll go down the centre first, and then I'll come in between at the sides. So you can see there it's sort of in between those previous portion of dot right at the sides. You just want to dot a small bit of gel and then use a pointed tool to move that around. So now we're going to top coat these.
Would you do two lots of top coat on there together if you wanted to smooth
them? Yeah, that's what I'm going to do. So I'm going to top coat, then I'm going to buff. And I'm going to do something else. I'm going to top this one, top coat this one anyway. I'm doing that because I'm going to buff the other nails and I don't want the dust to go on that nail. And because it's got a sticky layer, the dust will sit on that nail. Right, pop me that in. All right, so can you see how the gel makes it a little bit lumpy bumpy? You can see from that sort of side view there that the dots will make it raised. So I'm going to buff it. By buffing it, it's going to help. Oh, it does look nice, Matt. Oh, we were just mad on that. We're mad for Matt right now. But this is just going to help even it out. And then what I'll do, once I've done this, I can top coat it again and then it's going to be even smoother. You can even get a 240 grit file and go over it a little bit if you need to. Okay. I'm going to paint on this one, so I'm just going to buff that one anyway. Wipe over with gel residue wipe off solution, getting rid of the dust. I can feel that one's quite raised, so we're just going to file over that one a little bit. And we can top coat. Make sure you're capping the edges because we've already buffed and removed some of the seal, so you need to make sure you let that brush skip round the edges of the nail. That's going to prevent any peeling of the gel polish. Pop that in the lamp. Oh, I think they look better matte. Shiny or matte?
You can't ask them because they're going to watch it after this is done.
I know, but I think they might agree with me. We'll go matte. Yes, we're going matte. Let's buff them to make them nice and matte. Thus, smoothing the nail out at the same time. Mm. See, there's another reason for it. Just try not to go round the edges really because you don't want to break that seal. So we're going to use some white acrylic paint to create a bow. Because we all had bows in our hair. In the 50s, it was like the old neckerchief. Have a bow of a neck, you know, tied in a bow around your neck or a big bow in your hair. I'm just doing the outline really first of all. Oh, it's so pretty already! And I'm going to do stripes. So there's lots of stripes and dots. On this part that I filled in, I'm just going to scratch into the paint so I've got the lines just like that. Just going to go around the outside of the bow just to make those lines, those border lines, a little bit stronger. Stop moving. Well, let's top coat that and then we'll mat it off with a buffer. So now we're gonna do some sugaring. Not baking, we're not baking, we're doing some sugaring.
A little exciting then.
Right, what we're gonna do is use Snow White. Leave a little bit of that out. And we're gonna make a magic potion of clear acrylic powder. And some super fine glitter. Maybe a little bit more. Where's my lid? Where's my lid? That doesn't fit. Shake it up. Oh yeah, can you see? Oh, it's a bit glittery.
Mm-hmm.
That's the magic potion. The dress that I wore had like, at the bottom, it had big panels of white and it wasn't actually round at the bottom. It wasn't like a circle skirt. It was actually more of a handkerchief skirt. It actually had like these pointy bits at the bottom. That make, so if you held it up, it was square at the bottom. And it got these white panels. I'm inspired by that. Inspired, not spired. I'm inspired by that to do this next step. So we're going to do these shapes, this sort of like square shape, just portions of it. Now can you see why I mixed that colour in it? Because I knew I was going to use white and I didn't want the polka dot to get lost within this white gel polish that it looks pink to me. I'm going to do one here as well. Then we're going to sprinkle the nail with our magic potion. To create a sugared effect. Pop me that in the lamp. You need to cure this for twice the amount of time. So it's a 30 second cure, so we're going to cure it for a whole minute. Because the acrylic and the glitter will prevent it being cured as fully, and we want it a full cure. So we're going to repeat this kind of shape on the other nails. Do one sort of big one on this. So yeah, I'm going to put a little bit onto this nail as well. You like the tapping sound, don't you? Especially when you're editing.
Because when you used to use the metal implement, it used to go through me.
So we're going to dust off now all that little magic potion that we made with the acrylic and the glitter. So, oh, I love this, Luke. Had I only have known I was going to wear that outfit for our 50s themed little night out, I would have done these nails. Obviously it was a lastminute.com outfit. Let's put a bit of oil on now, finish with a little bit of cuticle oil. I don't want to pull that over all of the nail because I don't want to take away from that matte effect. We've never done matte with sugaring, have we?
Yeah,
I don't think we have. Sure. I think it looks lovely. I like it. There you are, guys. Hope you enjoyed that 50s inspired look on the fabulous Vanessa. Don't forget to check us out on Facebook and Instagram. Everything that I've used today will be listed below. So if you want it, check it out. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye.
Bit of hair.
Dangling
it. And I thought you'd just rubbed it against.
Oh, oh God. Don't keep messing.
Mess with my finger, the skin.
That's fine.
Didn't touch the nail.
Wow, oh, it's still close.
So. Get your own wardrobe.
Pink on that.
What? Pink?
The white bit's pink, don't you think?
Kirsty. You need to take a breath. It's not pink.
Stop moving. And out again, in, out, shake it all about. It's fine and dandy. La 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 la